Imagine joining Indian Army as a lieutenant if you have done your engineering in mechanical, civil, computer science, electrical or electronics. Indian Army has started their technical recruitment of 2025 and you wouldn't imagine the starting salary is touching 2 lakh rupees, nearly 2 lakh rupees per month. My name is Kushal Vijay, I work as a software engineer with Microsoft and I share a lot of content around opportunities on this channel. So make sure you subscribe so that you don't miss similar opportunities. Let's get started. So you'll go to the website and there is a recent notification of technical graduate hiring. So basically it's a course in which you have to go through the whole process of 12 months where you'll be trained and everything is taken care by the government. You won't imagine the per month expense of this training is pretty high. Per week itself is very high. And I'll be covering everything, how much does it cost per week, but government is taking care of everything. So eligibility, I'll simply say the eligibility is pretty simple. If you are an Indian citizen, first of all, the course is 142nd technical graduate course. It's a training in which you will be trained to be a part of Indian Army. And as obviously in whichever field you have done your engineering, you'll be working in similar sector of work. And also the eligibility is you have to be unmarried male. So sorry to all the female subscribers. It's okay, not this time, but in some other video I'll be covering a lot of opportunities for you guys. You have to be a citizen of India, which is there. You have to be the age of 20 to 27 as of January 1, 2026. So make sure if you are at the borderline, you should you should make sure you are applying if you are only eligible. Okay. Now, look, special emphasis in that you have to have these criteria fulfilled. Mismatch of stream should not happen. So they have given a proper table of streams in which if you lie in, if you have pursued that stream, then only you are eligible. Variation name, the document should be appropriately correct. Provisional degree and everything, mark sheets are appropriate. Then you have to be, you have to clear the physical medical test also. You'll be able to do all these physical, you have to match the physical standards because obviously our Indian Army, you'll be joining the Indian Army, you'll be serving the nation, so you have to be physically fit. You should be candidates who have passed their requisite engineering degree or are in their final year degree are eligible to apply. So if you're a final year student or already graduated, then you are eligible to apply. But there are a few restrictions here that all final year appearing candidates whose final year final semester exam will scheduled after 1st of January are not eligible. For induction to pre-commissioned training academy after final selection, the minimum educational qualification is passing BTech degree in engineering stream notified by the Para 3. So the process of selection will start and it will include the SSB interview also. And if you will be in your final semester, you will still be allowed because you will have to submit your CGPA or the application that you will be filling has to have information till 6th semester. So final semester year studying candidates are provisionally allowed to appear in SSB. The restrictions are their cumulative percentage of marks up to 6 semester of 3rd year of degree, up to 8 semester of 4th year of B.Arc, up to 2nd semester of MSc is notified in equivalent stream discipline is not below the approved cutoff. After declaration of final result, the cumulative percentage of marks will also be not less than the approved cutoff. Once you'll submit your application, there will be cutoff. If you will cross that cutoff, then you only will be eligible for your SSB interviews. Vacancies candidate must not note that only engineering streams and their acceptable equivalent streams are allowed. And here are the streams. So if you have done anything in your civil engineering, then you should lie in any of these streams and make sure you have pursued specifically. So they have specifically mentioned that stream name should actually match with the name they have mentioned in the list. Computer science IT students should check this list. Electrical students should check this list. And electronics students should check this list. And mechanical should check this list. So be precise in checking. And miscellaneous also, architecture students can check this one. Okay. Now selection procedure. The application process itself waits a lot. like it has a lot of weightage. You have to fill everything in detail, and that based on that application, based on your academic performance, you will get a chance for in. You will be allotted for SSB interview, and if you will be able to clear SSB interview based on your application performance and SSB performance and your academic performance, you will get a chance to join the academy in Dehradun. This is the only selection process. As I have mentioned, I have like summarized it to you guys. You can read it in detail in this. Then you will also have medical examination. So anyone who cleared everything in interview and performance, technical performance, but you have to clear the medical examination also, else you will be rejected. The Indian Military Academy in Dehradun is the place where you will be trained for almost 12 months. As far as I know, 12 months or 12 weeks, yeah. The duration of the training will be 12 months, and the benefits are crazy. Okay, so as a part of the training, you have to read all the details. Indian Military Academy, the government will be taking care of all the expenses, but if you by any chance, except for medical situation, if you want to get out of it, you have to pay liable to refund cost of 16,000 per week. Imagine, multiplied by 4, it equates to 64,000, which is like crazy number. Not even 64, it will be like more than 65,000 rupees per month. And this is the amount of expense government is taking everything on themselves and helping you train. But if you're not able to it's beyond your control and you want to get out, then this would be the amount you have to pay to the government. Okay, final allocation. So this is the lieutenant level, which is level 10. You will be hired at level 10 only, and see the pay scale of that role, which is 56,000 till 1,77,500, which is crazy amount of money. During the training, you will be a cadet. You will get a stipend of around 26,000 per month, starting pay in level 10 of pay matrix. And then after, during the training, you will be serving as a cadet. And on successful commissioning, the pay in the pay matrix of the officer commissioned shall be fixed in the first cell of level 10. And the period of training shall not be treated as commissioned service, because you will not be serving the nation in a training period. For the training period, you will be given the allowances as mentioned in this document. There are a lot of allowances actually. Qualification grant, other allowances like para-reserve allies, technical allies, transportation, meals, and a lot of things are being mentioned in this document. You can read it through if you want to. About the transport alliance, ration alliance, uniform alliance per year, so and so forth. Even children education alliance is also there. Hostel subsidy is also there. Army group insurance fund is also there. So there are a lot of things involved in this particular hiring, and you should apply if you are a student, engineering student, male, and have graduated in 2025 or already graduated. The most important part, how to apply. All you need to do is go on the Join Indian Army page, click on this button, officers entry, apply, login, and then you will have to register on joinindianarmy.nic.in. Once you have applied, a page officer selection eligibility will open, then click on apply. And then you have to apply against technical graduate course. A page of application form will open. Read the instruction and click on continue. Fill all the information like personal information, communication details, education qualification details of previous SSB. Save and continue. Each time before, obviously save your progress so that you don't miss it the next time. After filling details, on the last second you will move to the page summary of your information. There you have to submit, and then candidates will take out 2 copies of their application having roll number 30 minutes after final closure of online application on the last day. Once you will submit this, your application will be submitted, and obviously you will be called for SSB interview once you will have a center located. By the time you will go to the selection center for the SSB interviews, you have to carry your documents with you. The government is also giving you travel allowance if you are giving your SSB interview for the first time, like it is mentioned. See, these are minor things that are mentioned in this document. I would highly recommend you to read this again. Merit list will be generated. once you done with your SSB interview, and based on that merit list you will be selected. So it is noted that mere qualifying at the SSB interview does not confirm the selection. Merit list is prepared engineering stream subject wise in the on the basis of marks obtained by the candidate at the SSB interview. In case of equal SSB marks are obtained by more than one candidate, the older candidate's age will be ranked higher. So this is how the ranking will be done. All these things are mentioned here. You can request for changes and everything. The details are mentioned here. If you want to change your interview dates, it's not working for you, you can read these details in the document. As far as the deadline is concerned, 29th of May is the last date to apply for this. Please use the link in the description and apply for this. If you want more such videos on Indian Army or government related job applications, make sure you comment down and like this video so that I will be motivated to share such opportunities. I'll see you in the next video. Till then, bye bye, take care.